Assalamu alaikum. Well, here we'll take a look how to use Firebase Firestore to do CRUD operations. Now, to do that, first I'll come to my Android Studio and here I'll create a new project. And that would be a new Flutter project. console.firebase.google.com, and here we'll create a new project. Now we'll continue with the name, and some of you might not need this. It doesn't really matter. Okay, if you don't have Google Analytics, just disable it, then continue, and I'll select an account, and I'll continue and try to finish the project. It's done, then we'll continue. Now we'll create a new project and we'll choose Android. You can also choose iOS, it doesn't matter. Okay, now here the package name. Now to be able to get the package name, you have to come to your Android Studio and then this Android folder, then app folder, source, main, and Android XML over here. Now this is the package name. So we'll copy this one and we'll put it here. And then we'll register the app. Okay, now we'll download the JSON. Now what we'll do, we'll get this file and drag this into this app folder. Okay, so I'm trying to drag it to this app folder. So inside this app folder, we see googleservices.json. Okay, so it should be right inside this app folder. Okay, right after that, we'll continue. And we have to do some basic configuration. And mostly it asks you to add this three lines, but first one and the last one already been added, so we'll just go ahead and add it. Okay, so we'll copy this one, and for this reason we'll come to this build.gradle file. We'll add it over here. Okay, now this one they ask us to add, but it's already been added with the new version, so you don't need to add that. Okay, now we do for app level build gradle. Now over here mostly we need this three lines, the last three, but if you didn't choose analytics, so for you just this and this, and this has already been added actually, so we'll copy this one and we'd go ahead and do apply plugin. Now for this one we need to come to this build gradle over here. And as you see, it's already been added. So the first line we skipped, so we'd add the second line, which is this one. Now we'll copy third line and we'd find dependencies. Now dependencies are here. Okay. And now once again, this one is not important. This is Firebase Analytics. So you can skip that. But as I choose this one, I'll go ahead and add it right at the top of this. Okay, all right. Now with the new Flutter version, the minimum SDK should be 19, so we should change this one, otherwise it will get error. And we also need to enable multi-desking. Okay, well it didn't say in the documentation, but if you don't do that you will get error. So here we do. Okay, so make sure that you spell it correctly. All right, and with this we are done with the setup. So right over here we'll go back to our console. Okay, all right, now we'll start our app. So I'm using Android phone, Android emulator, and we'll make sure that we don't have any errors. Okay, all right, so as it runs we'll do the next thing. What's the next thing? The next thing is to download this plugin, Firestore plugin. Now to do that, I would come over here and right here I would write okay, great. Now we'd run our app again and make sure that we don't have any crash. Okay, so here is our app. Well, everything is working fine as we see over here. Okay, so now with this the basic setup has been done. Now the most important part is creating a Firestore database, and to be able to do that we need to come to our project here, Firestore database. You need to click on this, Now you can choose your database, the one that's close to your area, but I'm in Asia, so I'll choose Asia South one. Okay, so if you choose it close to your area, that would be fast to access, then we'll enable it. Okay, now we'll go back to our project, and over here we'll choose this one, main.dart, and right over here we'll delete everything. Now right below it we'll create a new stateful class. Okay, now at the top we need to initialize Firebase. So right over here we would do this one. So make sure you call this Flutter bindings and then you initialize Firebase. Okay, and at the same time we need to import them. And now we'll go back to our Firebase dashboard, and over there we'll create collections and documents. Now over here we'll click on this button which says that start collection. Now collection in Firebase is more like tables in MySQL. So when you create a new collection, you are actually create a new table. Of course you could have many tables. So we'll create a new table or a collection, and we'll give it a name. Over here, it's asking you to create a document. Now, document refers to the rows, okay? Now, each row should have an ID, so each document should have an ID. Now, over here, we'll create ID auto-generated, okay? Now, of course, in your row, you might have a lot of columns, so those columns are called fields, okay? Now, here, we'll define some columns or fields, and first one, we'll call it name. And we can initialize some default values for this one. And over here, I'll call it shirts. And then I'll create a new column or new field, and I'll call it price. And over here, the data type is a number. And then I'll give it some default value. And then it'll create a row with this two fields. So now it's trying to load. So here we created our first table. And in the table, we have a row. Now each row has an ID, so this is the unique ID. And the row has two fields, name and column. Once again, this is MySQL database table, this is MySQL row, and these are the MySQL fields. So that's how you should understand collection, document, okay, and fields. Now, after this, we'll go back to our project. Refer to our table, the table we created or the collection we created in Firestore. So now this line of code refers to the table or the collection in Firestore. Okay, so because now we'd be able to access this table using this instance, so we'd be able to do many operations on this collection or on this table. Because we can access this products instance or the product table, and we'd be able to use the add function, update function, and delete function on this table. Now we'll come over here, and over here we'll create a scaffold. Inside the scaffold, we created a stream builder. Now what does stream builder do? Stream builder would help you to keep a persistent connection with Firestore database, okay? By the body, we wrap it around using stream builder, and as things happens in Firestore or as we update data, because of stream builder, we would get the updated data in real time immediately. Now stream builder has a property which is called stream, and to this stream property we are assigning this snapshots. Now this snapshots is coming from this products. Now once again, this stream would help you to get a persistent connection with the database table for this products table over here. Right after this we have this stream snapshot. And this stream snapshot will have all the data that's available in our database or in Firestore. Okay, so over here we check for data, if we have data or not. Okay, if we have data, we show the data in list view builder. Otherwise, we just go ahead and show them this one. Now inside this list view builder, actually we access the data from the tables. So once again, I said that stream snapshot contains all the data. So that's why you can access the data using stream snapshot.data, docs, and length. Now earlier I said docs refers to the rows in database in Firestore. So here I'm accessing the rows and I'm trying to get the length of the rows, which means how many rows I have over there. So here we have this document, and because of this one, we'd be able to access the data from the row, and then I would save them in a document object. Now, ListViewBuilder would look through every data we have in our database. Now, once again, because this refers to the rows, this refers to the rows, and we'd be able to access the columns or the fields in the rows using their property, which is name and price, which we have created early. So name and price, which refers over here. So now we'll go ahead and run our app. And as you see, the data is trying to load, and we see shirts 20 once again. So let's load the data. Yes, so in our database we had early shirts and 20. Now to be able to work on it in real time, what I'll do, I'll go ahead and put the emulator side by side, and then over here I would create a new document, which means a new row, and we'll see that it reflects here immediately. And we'll set it 10, and then we'll save it. And soon we'll see that it updates here automatically. So as you see, so that's the beauty of Firebase Firestore, which updates data automatically without any interruption. So we are able to add data from Firebase dashboard directly. Now we'll see how to add data from our app. To do that, over here I'll create a new property which is called a trailing for list style. So in this icon button, as it is pressed, we want to update a certain document or a certain row, and for this reason we are going to create a method called update, and we'll pass the snapshot for updating the certain row. Because this row has this index, because of this index we can pinpoint a certain row. First we'll create text controller, and then we'll create update method. So here we created an update method, and at the same time when we call this update method, we are passing a document snapshot or object. And as we do that, first we try to grab the current value from this document object, and then we store them in name controller and price controller. And we have used a show model bottom sheet to show the data as we work on this. But now if you want to get the complete code for this one, just check out the link below. And most importantly, in this update method we have this method called products.doc.update. okay, now at the top over here, whatever the value we have currently in our database, we get that and store it. And right after that, we grab the value that's been changed in name controller and price controller. We save it over here in these two variables. And after that, we pass them in our update method, which is .docupdate. Now, once again, these methods are already built in Firebase API. All you need to do, go ahead and call them. Okay, now as we are trying to update, we need to pass the ID. Now the ID is coming from our document. Now we'll go ahead and run our app. Here we see that we have icons for updating. Once you click on this, we'll see that a bottom sheet shows up. So as you see over here, we see it. Now we can change it over here. So we'll set men's shirt, and we'll click update button, and we see that here it's updated automatically. Now we can verify it in our Firestore dashboard. So click on this one, the men shirt. So for hats, we don't see any change because we didn't make a change. Now we'll make a change from our app, and we'll see that it reflects here automatically. So for hats, I'll change it to women's hats. I'll click update. Now this is the time to add documents from apps. Now to be able to add items from our app, all we need to do, we'll go ahead and copy this update method, okay? Now we'll go ahead and copy it. We'll put it right over here. And instead of update, we'll call it create. Now inside this create method, we need to make a little change. Everything else stays the same. So let's remove this completely. So here we have products add. So now we'll go ahead and create a button so that we can call this create method. So over here we have our floating action button, and from the button we are calling create method, and we want to position the floating action button in the center. Now we'll go ahead and run our app. Now here we see that we have this icon button. Now this refers to the create method over here. We'll click on this and we see that a model sheet pops up. Now over here I'll write and we'll return. And here we see that we have this codes. Now we can verify that it's inserted in our Firebase database from here. So now we see that we have three records. So we'll click on the last one. Now here we see codes. To be able to delete an item, we need to create a new method, and we'll create the method right over here. Now here the method name is delete, and all it needs is a product ID. So we'll call it from the body of our scaffold. Now over here, we'll copy this icon button. And instead of sending the document itself, we can just send the ID, okay? So what we'll do, we'll click on this and we see it deleted immediately and we get a message. And we can verify it in our Firebase. Now we just have two items. Now we'll delete one more item and we'll see that it'll reflect immediately. So it updated automatically. Of course, we'd be able to create another one. But anyway, you see the idea that it created automatically. So yes, so that's pretty much all about Firebase and how to use it in your app. So if you liked it, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button.